Hello students, in previous session we have studied satellite communication in detail. Now today we are going to learn about digital communication. The transmission of binary or digital information from one point to another point is known as digital communication. Students, this digital word itself says that in this communication there is a transfer of information in the form of binary. Means in digital communication the information is in coded form. The coded information is made up of two distinct voltage levels represented by two numbers 0 and 1. This two level information is known as binary coded information. And type of signal can be digitized, therefore the transmission of voice, video or other analog information in binary form is also known as data communication. In this data communication system, the system allows the transfer of information between computers and also allow the remote operation of computer from a terminal. Okay students, and as all of you know that this is a digital communication related to binary information, and binary information can be represented in the form of zeros and one only. But binary pulses having two distinct states are called as digital signals, and each signal is represented by a voltage level. The pulses switch rapidly between these two levels. If we consider this pulse, so it is represented here one. But if we have to consider data from this part, so it is 0. In this way, this information is coded in the form of binary zeros and 1. Okay, students? Now, such binary signals having two levels. For example, binary 0 levels might be 0 volt or ground. And this binary 1 level might be plus 5 volt or VCC. And any other voltage levels can be used. Okay, student? So, the information to be transmitted is first converted into binary data or digital signal made up of these pulses. You can see this diagram. Here, you can see the data represented here in the form of zeros and one only. Okay, students? And binary signals can be easily generated by using digital logic circuit consisting of transistors. Binary signals can be processed with electronic circuits. These signals represent data or information. The binary signals are codes made up of groups or patterns of zeros and ones. So each pattern represents a numerical value, a letter of the alphabet or some special symbols. So in the digital system, the information in digital system is expressed in the form of some digital words such as bit, byte, nibble, binet and bots. So binet is nothing but representation of 0 and 1 symbol. Now next is bit. Students, can you observe this word? Bit is nothing but combination of binary digit, means first two letters shows that BI for binary and again IT for digit. Okay, students, so we can simply here analyze that bit is nothing but binary digit. So bit is one binary digit, either it is 0 or 1, or it is a combination of string. For example, if this data is here 01010, this data contains how many bits? Yes, this data contains 5 bits. So we can say that this number has 5 bits, means 5 binary digits. Okay, students? Next is nibble. This word represents a group of 4 bits. Means simply we can write here 1 nibble is equals to 4 bits. Means combination of 4 bits is nothing but 1 nibble. For example, we'll write here 1010. This is one nibble. 0100 is another nibble. Okay, students. So simply, nibble is a group of 4 bits. Next, byte. As nibble is a group of 4 bits, so byte is group of 8 bits. Can we write here 2 nibble is equal to 1 byte? Yes, 2 nibble is equal to 1 byte means the combination of both these nibble 1010100, it is nothing but byte. Okay, students. So byte is a group of 8 bits. So we can write here 1 byte is equal to 8 bits or 2 nibble. Okay, students? Students, as we know that decoder converts given data into its equivalent decimal and encoder converts the given data into its equivalent binary. So we can say that encoder circuit can easily generate binary data, and the data is made up of numbers, alphabet or symbols. Each data is represented by unique combination of 0 and 1. And it uses specified code system like ASCII means American Standard Code for Information Interchange, or EBCDIC. Simply we call it IPSIDIC. Students, all of you know that what is mean by ASCII code and IPSIDIC code. In paper 2, we have studied ASCII code, BCD code and IPSIDIC code. This IPSIDIC code is nothing but extended binary coded decimal interchange code. Okay, students? And this is a 8-bit code. So with this process, we can easily transmit any kind of information, for example, audio, video, photographs, etc. And the earlier data communication was the telegraph, which was invented in 1832, usually used by the post office to send telegrams. In this telegraph, the radio communication is used, and that radio communication is called as continuous wave communication. Okay, students? And that communication uses the Morse code. Morse code is a series of dots and dashes that represents letter of the alphabet, numbers and punctuation marks. The latest example of data communication are fax, cellular phone, email, pager and so many other systems use digital communication. Digital communication system becoming more and more popular due to its low cost, wide coverage and noiseless reception and effectiveness. Okay, students, now let us see Morse code. This Morse code, as I have explained previously in the point number 5, this Morse code is nothing but series of dots and dashes that represents letter of the alphabet, numbers and punctuation marks. This type of communication is a continuous wave communication, which is used in telegraph and invented by Samuel F.B. Morse. In this system, information is sent in terms of on and off position of key that keep producing sound of 2 durations. Now let us see how this Morse code is designed for each letters and numbers. You can see this chart represents letters and numbers designed in Morse code. For example, alphabet A is designed in the form of dot, dash. Alphabet B, single dash and 3 dots. Students, see this letter C is designed in Morse code with the help of dash, dot, dash, dot. Alphabet D, dash, dot, dot. Alphabet E, dash, dot. Alphabet F, dot, dot, dash, dot. In this way, all the alphabets are designed in Morse code with the help of only dot and dash. Now what about numbers? See, number 1 is designed with the help of dot, dash, 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 means single dot and 4 dash. Number 2, dot, dot and 3 dash. Number 3, 3 times dot and 2 dash, and so on. In this way, all the numbers, decimal number from 0 to 9 are designed with the help of dash and dots like this. Okay, students, here dot is short duration pulse producing short click in telegraph sounder, while dash is a long duration pulse producing long click. Okay, students, but one of the disadvantage of this system is only experts can read or send the message in the form of dash and dots. In telegram system, though the telegraph and continuous wave communications are still used for the most part, they have been replaced by telephone communications. And to overcome the drawbacks present in this Morse code used in the telegraph system, the newer system is developed ASCII code. ASCII is nothing but American Standard Code for Information Interchange. You can see the letters ASCII used in this ASCII word, so it can be pronounced like ASCII. Okay, this is an industry standard code developed nearly 30 years ago. This is 7-bit code used to represent 2 raised to 7 means 128 alphanumeric values as well as some symbols. Okay, alphanumeric values and some symbols. A sufficient number of code combinations are available to represent both uppercase and lowercase letters of alphabet, and this code allows manufacturer to standardize computer hardware such as keyboards, printers and video displays. Students, as this is a 7-bit code, the ASCII code format or arrangement is here X6, X5, X4, X3, X2, X1, X0. Here, this letter X is nothing but 0 or 1. So, here, the first 3 bits here are taken from the column in which a symbol appears, and the last 4 bits corresponds to the row. Means, for example, in this example, you can see the code 100001. This code is designed in ASCII format for alphabet A in uppercase. In this code 100, these first 3 bits are taken from column in which this symbol A appears. And all these 40001, these 4 bits corresponds to the row in which this alphabet A in uppercase is present. Okay, students? In the same way, you can see number 8. It is represented in ASCII 7-bit binary code 0111000. So, first 3 bits shows from the column in which this number 8 appears, and 1000, these 4 bits shows corresponds to the row this number 8 present in the ASCII code chart. Okay, students? In the similar way, alphabet A in lowercase is represented in ASCII code with the help of 1100001. Means this code is designed in ASCII for lowercase alphabet A, and in which first 3 bits are taken from the column in which this alphabet A in lowercase appears, and 0001, these 4 bits corresponds to the row in which this alphabet A in lowercase is present. In the similar way, 0100, 0110, this code is designed for and representation ampersand, then 0103 bits shows the column in which this symbol appears, in which this symbol appears, and 0104 bits represents corresponds to the row. Okay, students. Students, you can see this is a chart in which x6, x5, x4 represent first 3 bit information, x3, x2, x1, x0 represent next 4 bit information. Okay, students, as we know that first 3 bit represents the zone and next 4 bit represents the code or the row in which the alphabet or symbol is present. Okay, students, see here, as I have explained here, 0110 for ampersand and 010 are first 3 bit information, 3 bits represent for this ampersand. Here this plus is represented with the help of 010 and 1011 are the next 4 bit used for the row in which this plus is designed in ASCII code. Okay, students, and you can observe different type of symbols like at the rate, then equal to, greater than, less than, question mark, dot, slash, dash, comma. Okay, students, or opening and closing bracket. All these are designed in this ASCII code. This is a basic ASCII code chart in which information is given in the form of 7-bit code designed for uppercase, lowercase alphabet as well as different type of symbols. Okay, students, in this way, the main advantage of ASCII is its large combination capacity, and it can represent codes for lowercase and uppercase letters also. To enter ASCII, a keyboard is used, but keys are marked with known characters and internally these are converted into ASCII code by using encoder circuits. Let us see digital transmission methods. There are two types of digital transmission methods. First, serial data transmission, and second, parallel data transmission. Now let us see basic difference between parallel data transmission and serial data transmission. You can observe both the diagram. See, this diagram shows the parallel data transmission. Here at the left side, this is a 7-bit register. This 7-bit register consists of flip-flops, and this arrow shows here the 7 parallel wires called as bus. This is another 7-bit register in which we have to store the data, and this data is stored in the parallel fashion. Here in this method, all the bits of code word are transmitted simultaneously. The binary word to be transmitted is usually loaded into register containing one flip-flop for each bit. Okay, students, so there are 7-bit storage register in which 7-bit data is loaded. This data is to be transferred to the next 7-bit storage register by means of 7 wires. These are the 7 wires. The group of wire is called data bus. The parallel data transmission is faster than serial data transmission. So this method is not suitable for long distance communication, and this type of transmission is possible within computer circuits or in computer to computer network by using these multiple wires cable. Okay, now in serial data transmission, here data transfer in communication system are made serially, means each bit of word is transmitted one after another. As shown in this diagram, you can observe carefully. This figure shows the concept of serial data transmission. In this diagram, you can see This is a 7-bit code designed for letter U, and this starting bit is 1, then 0 1 0 1 0 1. It's transmitted 1 bit at a time. Here for this letter U, this data design being transmitted 1 bit at a time. The least significant bit is shown here. LSB is transmitted first, means the LSB transmitted first, then most significant bit, this MSB, is transmitted in a fixed interval of time. Okay, students? So, as here data is transmitted in serial fashion, it takes longer time to send data, and this method is suitable for long distance communication. This type of transmission is possible within telephone line for longer distance with less wires or cables. Okay students, in this way, by observing both this diagram, we can say that the data transmission is faster in parallel data transmission than the serial data transmission, because in serial data transmission, each bit of word is transmitted one after another. Okay, but here all the bits of code word are transmitted simultaneously with the help of 7 parallel wires or data bus. Okay students, now though the speed is not faster in the serial data transmission, but by making use of special logic circuit, it can be possible to send data with higher speed. Okay, there is a special technique for converting between parallel and serial and vice versa, and this can be done by using shift registers. Students, shift registers you can study in paper 2, digital electronics, in sequential circuit, after counters, in shift registers. Okay students, now in longer distance communication, the digital data is sent and received bit by bit in serial way by two ways, and they are asynchronous transmission and synchronous transmission. Students, you can see the comparison both of the transmission methods here. In asynchronous transmission, information from transmitter to receiver is sent character by character, but in synchronous transmission, information is sent block by block. Each block contains many words and characters. Okay students, you can see in this diagram, this is transmitter and receiver. Here clock is necessary to send the information from transmitter to receiver block by block. Here clock is not necessary to send information from transmitter to receiver, but as here information sent block by block, so clock is essential for synchronization. Each character is accompanied with one start and one stop bit for understanding start and end. But here synchronous pulses are sent after each block for synchronization. In asynchronous transmission, as there is a transfer of information from transmitter to receiver sent character by character, so the process becomes slow as each character contains start and stop bit. While as the information is sent in the form of block by block, so this process is much faster than asynchronous method. Next point, this asynchronous transmission is used for low volume, low speed applications like telephone line. Okay students, but here synchronous transmission is used for high speed, large volume communication like internet, computer network, etc. But there is one disadvantage for asynchronous transmission is low speed and the lines remains busy for long time. In case of synchronous transmission, as information is sent block by block, so large storage and clock is essential at both the ends. Okay, students. Now this is assignment number 7 from chapter 5th, paper 1. Question number 1st, write a note on Morse code. This question carries 3 marks. Question number 2nd, what are the types of data transmission methods? Explain that methods in detail. This question carries 4 marks. Question number 3rd, what do you mean by ASCII code? Explain it with suitable example. This question carries 3 marks. Students, send me answer sheet of this assignment number 7 in PDF format. Okay? So, in this way today we have finished different types of codes and different type of data transmission methods. So, this is enough for today's lecture. In next lecture, we'll see network in communications in detail. Okay, students? Thank you.